Hi ma'am, how are you? Yeah, so Roshani, tell me about now we are at Rani Bagh. The place is all about greenery and all, and plus you are known for social awareness for environmental purpose and greenery and all. But when you come to see in the news and all that the trees are cutting down and all that, so how will you define your anger? Because MNCs are using their projects by cutting trees and all that. So, kahin na kahin wo gussa aata hoga, frustration aata hoga, because they are cutting thousands of trees for their projects and all.
Yes. See, honestly, first thing what I understand is, anger doesn't help to solve any solution, any problem that is. It's not a solution to any problem. We need to think with our minds and try to see what we can do logically. There are people who are taking these battles legally, so that, see, being environmentalists, we are not the people who are here to create hatred. We are not here to show our anger. Of course, there will be a little bit of frustration adding on to it. But when we deal with these things more practically and logically, we can keep moving forward. One step at a time. There are a few people who are taking these into the court because certain things are going
on. I heard about Syed Haider.
Yes.
Because in Goregaon, there's a place. So they are cutting down the trees for metro.
That's the only urban forest in the world.
Which has almost largest count of trees and all that, in thousands number or something.
Yes, it has thousands, and it is not just about the trees. When we talk about the trees, we emphasize about the ecosystem. Cutting a tree meaning we are cutting down the habitat of the birds living over there. We cut down our oxygen, that is our lungs. And most importantly, the water problem that we are facing today is somehow connected to the trees.
Yeah, because if you're saying save trees, for example, so how we'll be saving the trees? First of all, we need to save water, which is very essential. Then after water, we need to save forest. Once the forest has been saved, then we need to save animals. So it's a kind of life cycle. But we are not saving water, so how will be saving trees?
You need to start saving the trees and start saving the forest. Once you save the trees and the forest, the whole circle goes automatically around. Once the trees are saved, the animals, the habitats of the birds, the wildlife is all protected, because that is their habitat, that is where they live. Secondly is, because of the trees, we will automatically get our oxygen. And most importantly, the trees are like natural reservoirs. The roots, the system down, the ground water is actually stored through the roots.
Because nowadays, if we study EVS or kind of those books, so we show it in books. कि इफ यू सेज अभी कोई मुझे आके बोले कि हमें 100 पेड़ लगाना है, सो आई विल बी लाइक यार 100 पेड़ लगाना पागल हो गया है क्या? यही चीज समथिंग विल बी लाइक कि मेरे सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म्स काइंड ऑफ दोस थिंग्स, सो आई विल बी वेरी हैप्पी. यार सोशल मीडिया आई विल बी लाइक मैं पूरा दिन उसमें निकाल सकता हूँ. बट इफ समवन सेज कि हैदर वी नीड टू प्लांट ट्रीज, सो आई विल बी लाइक यार ये कौन गधा मजदूरी करेगा?
नहीं, वो गधा मजदूरी करना पड़ता, बिकॉज we need to keep regenerating the environment. It needs to be refilled. Like hum jo ek matka hota hai ghar mein pani pi liya and the water gets over, you're supposed to refill it, right? Same way, the amount of wood, the amount of trees we are using, and the way population is increasing, the pollution is increasing, we need to keep on adding more trees, because on an average every day every minute football field is being destroyed.
Definitely, because see now, right now we are sitting in morning, earlier morning, it's a fresh air, but if you compare this to afternoon, so it will be, you
this
cannot
place
imagine.
This afternoon is as good as what you feel now, because the number of trees around, the plants, the greenery is so good, you can hardly make out you are in the city. Though this is a zoo, it is actually a botanical garden. Rani Bagh, the Veer Jija Mata Udyan, is actually a botanical garden, because they have such old trees and rare species also. There are tree walks conducted here. You can already feel now the difference. And even if you come in the afternoon, it is so pleasant and very fresh, very refreshing. And the the diseases that are growing day by day has, of course, all to do with the environment.
Yeah, because, and by the way, who inspires you? Because it seems that you are more attached to environment.
Yes.
So who is the inspiration, basically?
Certain things are inbuilt.
Definitely.
So, I mean, since I was a child, I was water, air, mm-hmm. the mountains, the trees, mm. that fascinated me more.
Gotcha.
The trees were always, you know, like very close to my heart. I remember when I was a kid also, mm-hmm. I would try to look at the sky through the branches of the tree.
Uh-huh.
I would try to search the moon sometimes in the night through the branches of the tree.
Oh, that was a great childhood.
Yes, so I have grown with the love for trees. I mean, though I had never planned,
mm-hmm.
I would do this professionally. I would get into environment conservation.
Mm-hmm.
And
you took this step forward, and also you got some excellence award. So what was kind of that award was for?
It was an excellence award on the platform of Indian conventions.
In which year? In 2018.
Year. Yeah, last year. That mm-hmm. was for award of excellence in environmental services.
Mm-hmm.
And in 2014, I was awarded the best woman entrepreneur
mm-hmm.
in nursery business and environmental services. Because I had started, it was in 2016.
Mm-hmm.
2014, I started my nursery.
Mm-hmm.
With the idea that I wanted to grow more plants.
Okay, very nice.
Me
so it's like nowadays, if you see the fields and all that, it's like grass hai, zameen hai. Lekin wo maza nahi hai jo ek hona chahiye. Because haan, wo ek feeling tab aati hai jab barish hoti hai. Wo smell something makes like towards the next level. But if you're saying what does SOW does basically?
It is serene opulence works.
Mm-hmm.
We are into basic thing is, I would say, everything on ground level to do with the environment.
Mm-hmm.
Everything, I would say, from planting trees to creating natural groundwater resources.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody says we want for the pollution, there is a problem. I said, trees is the solution.
Yeah, this has been, ye sab sarkar ko karna chahiye, basically.
सरकार तो करना ही चाहिए तो हम उनको थोड़ा थोड़ा पुश करते रहते हैं सेम वे एज वी जस्ट मेंशन दैट देयर इज सो मच ऑफ एंगर एंड फ्रस्ट्रेशन मी सिटिंग एंड जस्ट सल्किंग एंड गेटिंग एंग्री इज ओनली नॉट हेल्पिंग सो वी व्हेन द टाइम इज नीडेड वी हैव टू बी ऑन द ग्राउंड एंड से वी हैव टू बी एबल टू सेव व्हाट वी डिजर्व व्हाट
वी नीड टू सेव आवर नेक्स्ट जनरेशन
करेक्ट सो व्हाटएवर वी हैव गॉट इट हैज बीन पास्ड ऑन फ्रॉम द अर्लियर जनरेशंस So we cannot keep on destroying the environment in the name of development. That is the first thing I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Development is so much needed, but we have to start considering and giving this importance too. When we say about save water,
mm-hmm.
there is nothing like save water. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you very honestly.
Mm-hmm.
We need to harvest the water which is coming from the skies.
Definitely.
Now what is happening is, earlier we never even had to think of it because naturally our lifestyle was saving the water.
Mm-hmm.
Now, because of our modernization and concretization,
mm-hmm.
the water does not reach the earth inside.
Mm-hmm.
It does not refill the aquifers.
Mm-hmm.
So when we say save water, we have to start from the root, that is, start changing our lifestyles.
Because if you want to say something to youth, because what they are doing is, ki social media platforms pe they are saying ki there's a person, It's a portrait image or something. It's that a person carrying a mask and oxygen and he is in the forest.
That is to show. I think that is to express.
And the year it is given something 2050. Because right now where are we? We are targeting 2050. What will be happening to us? We'll be carrying a mask and all.
We will be no more. But the new generations need to be given the right that they deserve. And for that reason we need to save our trees, the forest, the natural resources. Which are not going to happen anyways. You cannot actually grow forests overnight. I can create a forest. It may take 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. But can I make an ecosystem? No.
We need to be, you can say humanity. We need to be in ekta form.
Yes, because the humanitarian force has to start working.
Mm-hmm.
We are losing on
because,
our
Because we are also losing interest in visiting zoos and all that. Because people are like कि यार आजकल zoo में animals नहीं हैं पेड़ पौधे हैं but फिर पेड़ पौधे के साथ वो लोग compare करते हैं animals को भी Because what they are doing is, like, companies, I don't know who do, they are, they want brands. And what does brands do? They want skins of the leopards, mugamuch, and all the crocodiles and all that. Yeah, and but they want to sell that thing to foreigners.
Now, why are they wanting to sell it? Because there are people who are ready to buy it. They're ready to give money. They're ready to give whatever. It doesn't matter. And it's like a self-ego, I would say. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm wearing something which is worth so many millions and whatever.
A pure leather of so and so animal.
Can, will you remove your skin and give it to somebody else to wear it? Impossible.
It's a something else. If you're saying, like, for example, it was like something $70,000 that it was a crocodile belt, pure crocodile belt, and it was like it's legal to sell that. So that was like it depends whether you wanna buy it or not. If you want to buy it, you can definitely buy it.
See, demand and supply goes hand in hand.
Definitely.
And certain things, if we want to stop, it has to start from the top.
Mm-hmm.
We have to start stopping it from the top.
Mm-hmm.
Only then the demand supply can be controlled. Certain things, like, as they are banned, though they are banned, still the poaching happens, still illegal sale happens. So when we start from the top and start adding more pressure to it, there should be zero tolerance on poaching. They should not be given any kind of concessions. I mean, they shouldn't be lenient in any way.
Even police should take legal action against them who are selling this kind of things.
True. So when there are laws made for it, we don't have zero tolerance to it.
They used to go in the forest and they used to find kahan milega hati ki uska daat mil jaye kahin se usko bech de.
That's the reason. If from the top we show zero tolerance, same way as when we say rape, it has to have a zero tolerance. You're not just killing.
You're killing the humanity.
It is, yeah, it's the mind. You're going to kill it for life. So I think there has to be zero tolerance for certain things. Like poaching. It is something which we cannot afford to anymore. At one time, the Maharajas used to go hunting. They never realized, and I guess that time it was access. But as we are growing and coming closer to the bad days, I would say, we are realizing the value.
Because nowadays we are in modern era.
Yeah.
So in this modern era, jo chahe wo kar sakte hai, chahe wo legal ho ya illegal ho. Because you cannot compare the tradition era where we used to love animal, we used to love trees and all that, we used to keep planting them.
That's because our mind and we are diverted to other things. The moment we start losing these things, everybody's gonna start realizing the value of it.
Definitely.
Because today we still have few trees. There may be a time when you may not see a single tree on the full road. And that is the time you will miss it.
And we have a most powerful stream by the name of social media. If we can convey the message from the social media, everybody, it will be like, okay, it's a serious issue and we need to take action against it. So our new generation can enjoy
the
environment.
Because these are finally God's gifts. You or me don't own it.
We are destroying it.
Absolutely. Like, I'll tell you very honestly, when I started this thing on social media 5 years ago, I used to have friends coming and telling me, and Roshani, is it okay you're giving these kind of posts and sharing these kind of things? I said, why? What wrong have I done? Have I committed any crime that I should get scared? It's just to create awareness that this is the importance of the tree. This is the importance of the environment. I'm not putting my fingers on you or blaming him. This is what is happening and this is the ground reality. So it's only when we start sharing, people start knowing, that is how the awareness is.
Definitely. So on this particular note, we'll take the general question from the public. Okay, Neha Sharma puchti hai ki hamare desh ke bachcho ko deforestation ke baare mein jagruk karne ke liye schools aur parents ko kya karna chahiye?
Basically, to create awareness about what we are already having with the children is we need to first introduce them to the place. They should be visiting more parks, more sanctuaries, more forests. There are so many places where we can go for treks, take them for mountaineering, hiking, have their holidays in more natural environments.
There are many things like Black Forest Mountains and where you can experience better than this area as well. So you'll be getting more experience, you'll be getting you'll be open minded. Because if you're saying that if you heard from news and all that ki aaj itna ped gira aaj utna ped gira, so it will be like aaj normal hai, like building collapse hoti hai, so it's like ki haan normal hai, buildings hoti hai collapse,
but ye normal nahi hoga agar wo bachchon ko hum bachpan se school ki trips se ya hum Saturday outings jayenge, Sunday outings jayenge, unko aisi jagahon par lekar jao jahan pe there is full of nature. Automatically when it is being destroyed, they start feeling the pinch because your memories are attached to it.
Yeah, for example, ek bachche ki gaadi hai which usse zyada attached hai, like 5 rupees, 10 rupees.
Correct.
Agar wo gaadi koi wo nahi hai, koi banda tod de,
tab wo dukh hota hai. Same way, agar main bachpan se 5 gardens mein jaati aa rahi hu, which is very close to my house. For me, 5 gardens is something I've seen it since childhood. I would not want to not see it.
And let's take an assumption that among that 5 gardens, there is a one garden and there is a one tree which is your favorite.
Yes.
And pata chalta next day that tree has been
chopped off. And you're going to feel so sad about it. Same way, I'm quite attached to Rani Bagh also since childhood. Now today I'm doing up the gardens and the landscaping and all. That's my profession. But I do it with extra enthusiasm because I'm quite connected to it from my heart. Same way when I visited RA, I visited so many forests, I go for treks, I go for, you know, I go to places.
How did you get this idea of doing landscape business?
I never started this whole thing as a business, honestly. I started, I told you, with the intention of just growing more plants. Because I live in a flat in Mumbai, which is having 6 rooms, that has all those grilled, you know, those balcony windows outside, and one balcony.
Yeah, from there you can see the
yeah, so earlier I used to just have those plants in my bedroom. Then it went on to more rooms and having plants in the whole house. And at one time I felt, wish I had a terrace garden, wish I had more place. I wanted this plant, I wanted to grow that plant.
Different types of plants.
So, and even as children, I remember my brother and me had grown an orange bonsai.
Achha.
This is when we were kids.
I do remember. मेरे स्कूल के पास भी था, दैट वाज अ ह्यूज ट्री और समथिंग.
सो व्हेन आई टुक अप दिस प्लेस इन शिरवल 5 इयर्स अगो, इट्स 5 इयर्स अगो व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड दिस नर्सरी थिंग, आई जस्ट हैड 1 लाख थिंकिंग दैट आई कैन ग्रो मेनी प्लांट्स इन 1 लाख. इट वाज नेवर टू ग्रो एंड टू सेल एंड देन टू मेक इट इनटू अ लैंडस्केपिंग एंड अ प्रोफेशन. एंड इन दैट 1 ईयर आई डिड एवरीथिंग फॉर माय पर्सनल सेटअप. इट वाज अ स्पिरिचुअल लर्निंग, आई विल टेल यू. It was on ground level where I worked, not at all with the idea that I'm going to sell. But the expenses I put in were so huge. Kept putting and kept doing. I think by the end of 10 months, I realized I should start getting back some money to, you know, I was asked questions at home.
You'll be getting rewards. You'll be getting rewards.
No, I had to answer at home. Where is all the money going? What are you doing? You're going away from Mumbai to Pune, but what are you doing exactly over there? I just kept doing and I grew plants, I started propagating. And from the first year I started growing trees, which many nurseries don't grow till date.
Achha.
They like to grow small shrubs and ornamentals and exclusive, you know, ornamental exotics and
the
all.
The kind of show off.
Yeah, the show plants and all. Of course they are needed too, but for me trees was always very close to my heart. So I started growing trees over there. And I started propagating shrubs, small plants and all. Within the first year, I had no qualifications academically into this, in this field, but there was a passion to keep learning.
Okay.
And I kept learning. And after 10 months, I realized that now I need some more money. I was struggling even for 500 rupees. And I said, chalo, let's take up some small garden work. Let's, you know, I have to pay so much money to the labor.
So,
and
what, according to you, a youth, a small kid, or even anyone who is going to school, or even our parents, उनको कैसे अपने students को या अपने बच्चों को बताना चाहिए about this environment, कि नहीं अगर कोई तुम्हारा पेड़ काट रहा है या किसी का भी काट रहा है, how you can save that? Because as I said, you किसी और की गाड़ी अगर वो तोड़ दे, तो वो कैसा उसको लगता है कि हाँ नहीं?
You must go the legal way. Nothing works without that. Call up the police. Call up the cops. Ask 100 to come and help you out. You can ask them for some legal documents that they've been given permission to cut.
There are many
trees.
Forest officers as well.
Yeah, forest officers, yes, but in the city I'm talking.
Achha, huh.
If it is in the city, we need to call 100 and the cops go and file an FIR that there is a
but
tree.
But they have reasons, na, ki, no, it's for the project.
So that is okay. Till they have a legal approval, if they don't have a legal approval, it's illegal.
Yeah, because you know what? If there is a shop, let's take an assumption. There's a shop. And shopkeeper has a problem because uska jo jhaad ka jo ped hai uske shop ke paas aata hai and jo bhi wahan pe jo kharidne jata hai usko thoda you know congested lagta hai because of that ped and
but
all that.
There is no reason for chopping off the tree.
But they do this.
They do it because those people don't realize the value of the tree. Mm-hmm. They do not realize the value.
And what if they don't have any other option?
What is another option?
Like for example,
shop ke bahar tree hai, to uske aaju baaju se to ja sakte hain. Tree pehle se tha, shop aapka baad mein aaya. So who has the right?
Yeah, right. This is the second question.
Kya hota hai? Just because the trees don't talk, they are not able to express their feelings. We take everything for granted.
Yeah.
Same way today, we are destroying the leopards' habitat, the animals, the birds, just because they cannot talk.
I came to a maine ek book padhi thi. I don't remember the book name. It was some James Mickle wrote. So James Mickle ye bolte hai that he met a tree. He is writing according to his assumption. He met a tree and he asked tree that what happened? You are very sad or something. So wo tree ne kaha ki mera jo dost tha wo subha kisi ne usko maar diya. Matlab chop and all that. So he was saying ki nahi mera dost ko maar diya ab mera koi saathi hai nahi main akela hu main tanha hu main kya karu. So wo ek tree ki biography ko bayan kar raha tha.
The tree also has feelings. The tree also goes through whatever. See, I'm not a very technical person in that, but through changes today when
sentimentals.
Yeah, see, we are just expressing it. Even they express it, it's only that we don't see it. When you see the tree ka leaf becoming yellow, there is a reason behind it. When you see some usme kuch keeda bhi aa gaya, so there is a reason why that has happened. And then we are treating it. Same way, if you're going to not give water to the plant, is it not going to show some reaction? It'll start drying out. It will start deteriorating. Same way, like if we are deprived of food and oxygen, what will happen to us?
We'll be in a deep trouble.
Correct. Only thing is, we are able to say it out. They don't speak. That's the only difference. They are living things. And more than anything else, they give selflessly, endlessly to us.
They take carbon dioxide, give oxygen.
To oxygen, to the bees, for the pollination, everything. Beautification is also one factor. We forget everything.
Rahul Joshi says, "Paryavarana Prerna." Right? I'm spelling right. Perfect.
Yeah,
right?
Paryavarana Prerna.
क्या है इसके बारे में आप brief में जानना चाहेंगे?
Paryavarana Prerna is a national organization committed to the cause of environmental and the biodiversity destruction happening.
You're the state president as well.
State president of Maharashtra. Though I don't do great much by putting banners and all behind, but I do whatever I can do in my own way. And that is how 2 years ago, Jal Star Ramesh Goyalji, he is the president of India for this organization. He must have seen me, you know, talking about the trees and having those things where I want to speak up for what we deserve. The conservation part. So he had straight away said that I nominate you and I want you to take it over and do it a little bit more and start an office and all.
Very
I told
nice.
Him very clearly that time also, I will do what I'm doing under your banner also, but I really don't get the time to do those things.
Are they financing or something?
No, no financing.
Achha.
I don't take any finances. Whatever I do little bit here and there is on my own.
Okay. We'll take the questions for women empowerment. आपके हिसाब से मॉडर्न इंडियन सोसाइटी में क्या जेंडर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन होता है? लाइक लड़का है तो ये नहीं कर पाएगा, लड़की है तो नहीं कर पाएगा, बिकॉज वी हैव आज भी वो सोच है हमारी. बिकॉज एज यू सेड दैट यू आर द प्रेसिडेंट नेक्स्ट इन महाराष्ट्र स्टेट प्रेसिडेंट इन
पर्यावरण.
हाँ, दैट वन. सो इसमें कैसा है कि यू आर द वूमेन इन दैट पर्टिकुलर, बट नाउ डेज इट्स लाइक कि नहीं एक लड़की नहीं बन सकती है नहीं कर सकती है. तो yes, सोच आज भी वैसी है.
ये तो इट्स अ नॉमिनेशन एंड आई एम जस्ट रिप्रेजेंटिंग द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. व्हेन आई हैड स्टार्टेड माय वर्क इन पुणे लिविंग इन बॉम्बे आई वाज नेवर टोल्ड दैट यू कैन नॉट डू दिस बिकॉज यू आर अ लेडी. ऑफ कोर्स देयर वर issues I face with my family, that is my parents, my husband.
Mm-hmm.
What is the need to go and start doing some work in another land? Like, of course, Mumbai and Pune, it's a different city.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to travel 4 hours by Asiad bus to reach Shirwal.
Mm-hmm.
So there were these kind of things. I think that was more out of insecurity and caring.
Insecurity to aaj bhi hai because kahin jaane nahi dete. किसी से मिलने नहीं देते.
नहीं ऐसा नहीं है इतना. इट इज ऑल ऑन यू व्हाट यू वांट टू डू. आई डिड नॉट लिसन टू एनीबॉडी. आई सेड आई हैव लिव्ड ऑल माय लाइफ फॉर एवरीबॉडी. आई डिड फॉर माय इन-लॉज. आई लिव विद माय फैमिली, माय हस्बैंड, माय टू सन्स. आई डिड व्हाटएवर वाज नीडफुल. आई फुलफिल माय ड्यूटीज. ऑफ कोर्स आई एम नॉट गोइंग बैक. आई एम नॉट यू नो टेकिंग अ स्टेप बैक फ्रॉम माय रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज. दैट इज गोना गो हैंड इन अंटिल आई एम अलाइव.
Mm-hmm.
But I said I want to do things that I want to do. I was always very enterprising. I would love doing small things, and I think this was one.
Because they used to demotivate lady entrepreneur. No, you are a woman. How you can be an entrepreneur? As compared to man, it's like ki haan tu ban jayega.
True. See, we have to prove it to them that they are wrong. Even when I started, my bua was insecure. She was scared that you're starting exports. It's going to be so. If you fall in trouble legally, and then there were my parents who kept feeling that, my God, what is she doing? She's putting all her money in this. See, your assets are going. I'm spending my savings. And of course, they were insecure and my mother would cry. My father used to get angry and tell me, what business sense you have?
And now what are they saying?
No, within 2 years, they were all quiet. they saw that I am doing some good work. See, initially because I used to go from Mumbai to Pune, so they didn't know what. They knew I'm doing something, but nothing was
exactly. क्या है वो नहीं पता.
And I'm a little headstrong. If I want to do it, I will do it, and I will do the best. I don't back out. So I kept doing, and automatically, you know, people start seeing the work, and when it is appreciated by the outside world, automatically they start realizing that this is the reality, and good is happening.
So what would you like to tell those moms who does not allow their daughters to become entrepreneur, to become like you can say, aaj ke daur mein they are not been allowed to go somewhere else or even not to allowed to meet with somewhere else.
That is something very wrong. Of course, I do believe this ages long thing. You know, the belief of. I would still want to look after my house, my family, because women are somehow made stronger than men. I would never call we need a thing called women empowerment, because women have always been stronger since ages, decades, centuries. The things that women can achieve, men cannot even come 50% close to it. In times of trouble, it's the women of the house who actually stand, you know, through those storms. There is no point in saying that the girl is not supposed to go out, the girl cannot do this, the girl cannot do that. In fact, the girls are far superior and stronger emotionally than men. So without women, the men are nothing. And of course, the woman needs the man's support too.
So, and we'll take a last question.
See,
what would you like to tell our forest minister about our environment, like about deforestation? What you wanna tell our forest minister? So any message for him?
The Minister of Environment and Forest Department.
Yes.
A huge responsibility has been put on your head. Hope it is executed with sincerity, loyalty, and keeping, you know, the goal set to protect the environment for the future generation. I would always keep saying you need to save the trees, the existing trees and the forests. And you can keep continuing with plantations, because if you go to compare, a sapling cannot be compared to a full-grown mature tree. You can plant 100 saplings in place of a tree, it is not done. You can keep planting. Even I plant. I just finished a 1600 plantation last week, Saturday, Sunday.
Where it was?
It was in one of those schools which help, you know, children from the tribal community and the underprivileged.
Nice. See, if they, if the schools take this initiative, like how to plant, because agar bachpane mein hi unko batayenge ki plant kaise karna chahiye, which soil, how to fertilize it, it will be better for them. Because school mein kaise sikhate, how to write letter, how to post it, and wait that letter
aur
should be.
Aur kya sikhate hain? A B C D. Jack and Jill went up the hill. Rain, rain, go away. Isn't that wrong? Of course, even I've done that. But over a period of time, I realized we as parents also need to work more on ground reality.
We are showing that T for trees, yes. G for green. But we are not implementing in our life.
Yes. So for that, we have to start sowing the seed at home. If we have a small plant at home, you start sowing the seed and see the seedling nurturing and all. Usse kya hota? You start understanding and attachment create hota hai. So the child automatically learns the values of the environment.
People used to love artificial flowers and all that for show. They don't want ki yaar ab kaun roz pani dalega.
Yes. Aur kyunki a plant rakh diya ya beautiful bhi kar diya, it goes. So they don't understand it needs nurturing. Like I have children. Today if I'll talk to them about the environment, and they think, okay, I'm also just giving a lecture and preaching. But deep down I know that love and the respect for the environment is there.
Do you think ki environment pe koi subject hona chahiye for college students?
Of course hona chahiye. School mein bhi hona chahiye.
There are management studies for sure. There are advertising.
College walo ko practically hona chahiye. Go and do
field work.
In school there has to be the basic theory and the knowledge has to be taught. By the time they come in fifth standard, they can do so much. I had pot culture in my school.
Acha, nice.
In my 8th and 9th or 9th and 10th, I had pot culture. You were supposed to grow a plant and this and that and take it by the end of the year to show, and we were given marks for that.
Oh wow.
Same way, Don Bosco has a nature club.
Convent kind of schools, ICSE.
No, SSE.
Achha.
I'm not a person who says that ICSE hona chahiye, CBSE hona chahiye, IB hona chahiye. I'm from an SSE. I put my children in SSE. Honestly, I don't feel that that will bring the change. The change has to happen from within.
Definitely.
It's not the school that makes the child. It's the child that will make the school.
Definitely.
Proud.
So what are your upcoming plans?
I want to do a lot of tree plantations. Wherever I can get an opportunity. Filhal to I spend maximum of my time in Rani Bagh in Mumbai, because I've taken this up as a project very close to my heart, making habitats for the animals, the exhibits which are coming up, and landscaping the area around, making it beautiful, because finally I am a Mumbaikar. It's like very close to my heart.
Yeah, definitely.
I love Mumbai. So this is the immediate thing going on since the last 3 years at least. It will go on for another long time, but side by side I keep doing, I take up projects for beautification, landscaping, and
any workshop or something?
Yeah, I do that, provided somebody organizes it, meaning coordination of creating the group. I really don't get the time to do that. In fact, yesterday only I got a call from Children of God or some NGO. They said, will you do it? I said, oh, I would love to do it. Okay, what will you charge? I said, nothing. I don't charge anything for workshops or teaching. Or
very
whatever
nice.
I can share my knowledge. And that is how I've done earlier also. I used to do something in Don Bosco also. I never charged for it, except for whatever material and labor costs. And I want to do a lot of afforestation, restoration of the forest.
And stop deforestation.
Wish I had that power in my hand.
So I hope so, and so wish you all the best for your upcoming
thank
plans
you so much.
And thank you for joining our show.
Thank you so much. It was nice talking to you.
Yeah.
Thank you.